we automatically figure it in. We all, and, you know, roughly about 4%. They're always going to ask you for 6%, by the way. They don't need 6%. Okay, that is the mortgage broker padding his fees. They can do it at 3% and 4%. Okay, let's go to the next page. Sign up for a buyer's list. Like us on Facebook. I promise that won't come back to haunt you. I'd like to wrap up the presentation with some motivational stuff. If you're going to have a team, whether they're directly working for you or it's a title company, a realtor, your employees, maybe some independent contractors that you have working for you, they're all on your team. You want to inspire your team, and you want to have good core values. If you have good core values and ethics, they're going to sense that, and that's going to help them make the right decisions as well. If you start making the wrong decisions and they see that, they're going to start to cheat too. And they're going to take shortcuts, and they're going to skimp on the rehab. If you inspire and motivate and help other people achieve their goals, you will achieve your goals. Educate, believe, and commit to personal growth. Lead and take action, motivate, and no excuses. And this is that little inner voice between your ears that we talked about that haunts everybody. And that little voice is the only competition that you really have. And enjoy the journey. Do it with passion and kaboom, right? Everything you do, you should have passion. If you don't have passion, pick something else. Find another field that you do have passion. UVSU, that's that inner voice. Everyone has the opportunity to be great, but not everyone will be great. Matter of fact, the majority of people won't be great. Take on that little voice. Learn how to live with it. The successful people, they still have a little voice in their head, but they know how to deal with it. They know how to handle it. Admit publicly you screwed up. Get educated in your business. Education removes doubt. Doubt removes fear. And fear will cripple you. Fear puts you back into your comfort zone. You know, when I went from doing one house to three at a time, that was uncomfortable. That was very uncomfortable. You know, I had some anxiety. You know, I'm doing three rehabs. I got $400,000 out in the street. You know, when I went from four to seven, that was uncomfortable again. You have to be uncomfortable or you're not going to change. And there's a winner and loser in all of this. You know, it's the whole rich dad, poor dad thing. Everyone has successful people. Again, they just know how to manage that voice between their ears. Recognize it. Own it. Take positive steps. You are your fiercest competitor. The world is a changing place. And it's not getting any easier. So what we have to do, we have to rise above it. We have to bring our A game. And we have to get out of the murkiness of mediocrity. And the past doesn't matter. Your past failures, I don't care if you were bankrupt three times. There's great men that have been bankrupt three times, turn around and made another fortune. They don't quit. They don't give up. Slow and steady progress, and you will reach your goal. If you don't change, if you don't get uncomfortable, next year, you'll be at the same place you are right now. So ask yourself, next year, on this date, you want to be at the same place you are right now. I don't.
Kaboom!
Anybody ever hear the name Pat Precourt? friend of mine. We had a lot of beers together at Fortune Builders events. He was the one that he really ran all the coaching with the students and with the coaches. He would do the weekly webinars for the coaches. He's a great guy. He's no longer with Fortune Builders. He struck out on his own. And I encourage everybody to go to patprecourt.com. He's now doing life coaching as well as business coaching. And I'm telling you, this guy, and I've seen a lot of motivational speakers. I've listened to Colin Powell and all the real estate owners, Tommy Hopkins, Ziegler. When Pat talks, it could be 1,000 people in the room, you can hear him. You hinge on every word. He's amazing. Great guy. Little Irish dude up in Vermont. So check him out. I got this from Pat, and I have this behind my desk. And I look at that every day when I get to the office. Whatever it takes to motivate you and pick your spirits up, you do it. So I'm going to go through this real quick. I'm the only voice. Do not listen to other voices. Don't listen to your relatives or your friends who are not successful and are telling you, I don't know if I'd do that, that's pretty risky. Only listen to your voice. I will lead and not follow. I believe in me and not doubt. I will create and not destroy. I love that for one person. I will defy the odds. I will ignore negative people. How many people know negative people, right? Yeah, ignore them. Matter of fact, stay away from them. Don't hang out with them. Don't go to the bar with them. Don't go out to eat with them. Avoid them like the plague, because that's what they are. They're a plague. I will set a new standard, and I'm a force of good. I will make a difference in someone's life today. I will step up to the plate, and I will never, ever, ever give up. Thank you. Thing real quick, I missed something I wanted to touch upon. I thought about while I was speaking. With these networking groups, I never understand why when it's over, everybody runs out. I don't know if they're missing their favorite episode of the Kardashians or what they're doing, but this is the time that you get to know people, that you share ideas. Or I've sold 2 wholesale deals out of this group that I presented. So this is the time to network, build relationships, and possibly in the future do a deal with one of them. Thank you.